Welcome to Fields United Methodist Church. We are genuinely delighted to have all of you here with us this evening for this special evening of ministry coming to you from the music program at Fields United Methodist Church. It is a genuine delight to have you here visiting with us. If this is not the church that you normally worship at, if you would like to come visit with us for worship, we would like that too. And we're here every Sunday, so feel free to show up. But we really are, it is a special pleasure for me tonight, because the folks that you're going to get to hear have a very special place in my heart and in my life, in that they adopted me some 27 or so years ago, and have put up with me since then. And in return, I have had the extraordinary to live with them and to hear from them in their musical capacities time on end. And it is a genuine delight that I'm glad that we'll have the opportunity to share with you here tonight. Some of you will recognize that some of these folks have been here with us in times past. We've had one here and two there and so forth. But this is the first time we've had the great pleasure to have them come visit us as a group. There are still some others that are part of this Before Viego family chorus that can't be here with us here tonight, but they certainly will be here with us in spirit. In a moment, I will like to say just a little bit more about them, but before that, a few administrative things. We delight that you're here, and part of the delight of that is that we have the opportunity to share hospitality and fellowship with you, so that after the concert tonight, down in Fellowship Hall, which is out this door and to the left, there's some goodies there, and you have the opportunity to greet and meet and spend some time with the singers, and also to enjoy some time of fellowship with each other. On your way, don't miss the opportunity to share your love with others through the Fields Music Ministry. If you would be caring to make a donation, there will be some folks there with a basket to receive your love offering. Before we begin, let us bow our heads. Gracious God, we thank you so ever much for the privilege to share ministry with you. You pour out your gifts as you see fit upon each of us. Some of us are gifted to teach, others to preach, others to study and to share our knowledge and discernment with others. And yet there are those that are blessed by your special blessing of artistry, whether it be in graphic arts or in performing arts. We are especially blessed, and we thank you, God, that you have brought to share with us this evening the Flor Viego family chorus. And we pray, Lord, that you would speak through them, even in that music which is not by its design religious music, but rather let us hear your voice even through the talents of the composers and the musicians here tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. This time I'd like to welcome the Flor Viego family chorus, if they would come forward. Throughout the Cleveland area, and there's some more about him in your much for being here with us tonight, Jerry. I have just a few notes that I will draw to your attention, and if anybody would like to raise their hand, when I make mention of something, when I speak of the eclecticism of this group, I'm just going to mention some of the professions that these people engage themselves in and day out. Like an opera singer, for one. A pathologist, for another. College professor. Public school teacher. Telecommunications specialist. Ophthalmologist. Medical technologist. Hospice chaplain. Certified operating room nurse. Software specialist. Nurse anesthetist. High school student. Computer analyst supervisor. Homemaker and mother. Yes. Yes, we have several of those. And a music major graduate from it. We have a number of those. And so the talents that will be shared with you tonight grow out of a family history of music that lives on because of Anita Gonzaga, and she is the foundational cornerstone of what we are about to hear tonight. Also, the parents of the LaFleur family who helped their children to learn and to engage in music. But in both cases, they brought these people up to share their talents in the name of God and for the glory of God. And with that, we look forward to feeling that joy and that joy.
Thank you. It is a pleasure to be here at Fields tonight, a part of your artist series. You have to understand that our family gets together for fun more than as a professional choral group. If we ever took ourselves seriously, would probably be doing Carnegie Hall. We actually started as the Gonzaga family group way back in the early 60s as a number in one of our mother's concert in the Philippines. She was a concert singer. Several moves and marriages later, we got together to do a Thanksgiving concert to honor our youngest brother's recovery from a 6-week coma. And after that, we would do a family concert several more times, adding spouses, children, and in-laws. Now, we don't know whether it is by design or coincidence that all our family are musical, including Harry. It is almost an unspoken agreement that you have to sing or play an instrument to marry into the family, or as we joke, you have to audition to get in. Before we begin, let me introduce the members of the chorus. It was exciting to realize that we became a 4-generation chorus last year. Our uncle, Dr. Isaac Aurelio, will be the first generation from West Virginia and is a tenor. And our granddaughter, Cassie, uncle's great grandniece, is one of the sopranos. The rest of the sopranos are Mary Mae Gonzaga Riego, Mayan Beflor Finkbaum, and Anna Isabel Riego. Our altos are Hazel Beflor Oldham and Amy Hill Beflor. Tenors are Eugene Beflor, Ed Beflor, and Dr. Phil Moriego. Basses are Gabriel Beflor and Tony Gonzaga, a unique tenor who can sing bass. And really tonight, the main attraction is Tony, because he's the only one of the siblings who decided to take music seriously and make it as his profession. So he will be the main attraction tonight. And since I am the oldest of the Gonzaga siblings, I decided I would direct the group. And of course, to get Jerry to accompany us with a fantastic father. After tonight, Jerry, I think, will make you an honorary member of the family. After our mother's memorial service 3 years ago, we printed the words to the song that she always included in her concerts. The song that spoke of her life and the legacy she handed down to us. And so we begin our concert, and we always begin our concerts with, "Let All My Life Be Music."
Let all my life be music. sing bass and tenor at the same time. Well, not quite at the same time. And since we're in the church, we mentioned the fact that we're not singing all religious songs. But music has a wonderful effect on everybody, no matter what kind of music. That's debatable. But most. Anyway, I would like to dedicate the first song. We were supposed to go to Ireland, but we're not. I'd like to dedicate this song to two of the loves of my life. I won't tell you who it is, but you can guess. And they are the sunshine of my life. And in Italy, when you go down to Naples, you have a wonderful breath of fresh air and sun. O sole mio. kept singing the wrong one time. I looked at my accompanist with a glare in my mind. He looked at me and says, well, you are singing the wrong song. So just to make sure I'm doing the right thing, I would like to move to Broadway, if I can find it. And this wonderful song from the man from La Mancha, which is an inspiration for both young and old people, The Impossible Dream.
Granada. Granada, tierras bonitas.
Our family grew up loving Broadway and light opera music. I remember Mom and Dad playing Jeanette MacDonald and Nelson Eddy records over and over. I see some of these young people that do. And how many of you remember it?
Oh,
thank you. Anyway, we have fond memories of performing in school musicals and at the theater that we decided tonight to include two of our favorite Broadway songs, Climb Every Mountain and You'll Never Walk Alone.
Thank you.
And they had cast me several times in a very beautiful opera about a Chinese legend. And I mentioned the fact that I was Oriental. I don't know why they put me as a Chinese prince. But in this opera, he is given the task of, first of all, he goes into this crowded town square, and there's a beheading going on because the Prince of Persia was not able to answer the three riddles that this beautiful princess had asked him. He wanted to marry her, but she said, before you can marry me, you have to answer three questions. Well, it's always nice to be a tenor because you don't get beheaded. See, what they do is they give you the answers first. And you have to memorize it. And if you don't, then you get beheaded. But anyway, he does answer the question. And the princess looks at him. Now she's a soprano with a big voice, and now she's a big soprano with a voice. And she says to her father, who's the emperor, says, I really don't want to marry this guy. I want to stay the ice-cold princess. And the father says, no, you gave your word. Well, this prince says, wait a minute, I want you to love me. And the prince says, well, okay. Now, what do you have to do? He says, okay, what I do is, I will give you one question. He is an unknown prince. Now, the whole audience know who he is, but this silly princess doesn't even know his name. Nobody told her yet. And so she said, if you could guess my name by the break of dawn, I would gladly go to the gallows and lose my head. He's lost his heart already, so now he's ready to lose his head. Opera is crazy. But anyway, this is an evening. She sends all of her troops out. Now this is an emperor. He says, you've got to find the name of this person. And in this search, this beautiful, wonderful evening, he sings this wonderful aria. When he says, oh, I'm sorry, princess, but you will never guess my name. And tomorrow, I will be victorious. The very end is in this vincero, which means I will be victorious. Oh! 7 dialects.
Thank you.
very simple prayer. I'd like you to, if I pronounce,
I have been praying, but that did not make it appear on my piano.
You don't see that because it's hidden. And sometimes when you sing and you make a mistake, the prompter goes, "Oh no!" Then you look at her and she says, "Did I make a mistake?" I says, "Yes, you have." So, just like what they were telling us, there was a staging of a Wagner opera. The Wagner is a very long opera. Very, very long. I've had some Wagner in my life, and I never want to sing one again, especially the Tristan. But anyway, they never finished the stages for the chorus. Now, Jerry was telling us the story. And what happened was, the stage director said to the chorus, just do what the prompter does. So, chorus was at the front, and he picks up the sword, and he picks up the sword, and the spear, and he moved it over. And then she said, he said, put it on your chest. So everybody, all the chorus is in their chest. And just about that time, the tenor comes in. And it was an awful voice. So the prompter forgot that he's not supposed to do anything. He's supposed to give the instructions. So all he said, when the tenor started to sing, he went, "Oh no." Everybody went, "Oh." So bored of the opera, they went home. So there was no firing squad. So the stage director friend said, cut the climate. So they're always the people who are in the fire department. So they have the right. So put the costume on. You're supposed to be the firing squad. Good. So they march off and they come. And they look and say, who are we supposed to kill? And on this side, there's a guy that's very calmly with his hands behind his back. And there's this soprano that's absolutely crazy. So they said, we might have to shoot this girl, this lady, so that we could, you know, stop her from all these hysterics. So they point at her, and she goes, no, and they shoot, and this poor guy falls dead. And so the director says, follow her, she's supposed to jump off the wall. So she runs up and jumps off the wall, but they couldn't find a mattress. All they found was a trampoline. So the firing squad runs after her, she jumps off, and it bounces right up. And the firing squad jumps off and bounces right up. That was the end of the opera. Anyway, this very simple prayer, this became very complicated, is something that I think you'd love if I could pronounce the words correctly and understand it. It's a prayer perfect, very simple song. And I wish you keep that beating through your hearts.
Thou art Lord.
done for. And so when my sister-in-law said, I have an accompanist for you, and I kind of held my breath a little bit, and I thought, okay. But when we met Jerry a month ago, I was just thrilled. He sat down and he said, oh, I know that, and just went to town. So we are just so privileged to have Jerry.
Thank you.
funeral, there were 40 of us that sang. But it is so hard to round them up. I mean, they're all scattered. And so